Hello friends, once again welcome to my channel. So friends, here today we are going to learn about something about literary clubs and movements. These are important literary clubs we can see here. Friends, before that let me tell you that I have enlisted some of the important books for English literature in the description box. You can go and see there's the list of books, and you can follow the links and you can buy the books from websites. So friends, this is for your reference only. Friends, you can buy, if you want to buy books, then you can buy it. Friends, for this video, let me tell you that we are going to learn about the brief detail, friends. Brief detail of different clubs and their writers, friends. So let's begin with the brief details of different these writers. So first of all, Kit Kat Club is there. Kit Kat Club is very famous word used for the association of Whig leaders of 18th century. Whig leaders of 18th century. And they first met in the tavern of Christopher Kett, whose mutton pies were called Kit Kats. So tavern of Christopher Kett, whose mutton pies were called as Kit Kats. That's why this name was originated from that particular word, Kit Kats. Then the members of these particular clubs are Richard Steele, Joseph Addison, William Congreve, and Robert Walpole. We can remember these names very easily because these are famous names in the history of English literature. Richard Steele, Joseph Addison, William Congreve, and Robert Walpole. These are called as Kit Kat Club members. Then friends, Beat movement, very important movement in American literature. It was emerged in America and Allen Ginsberg, very important figure here. He was the founding father of the Beat movement, friends. Founding father, the originator of this movement, Allen Ginsberg. And his poem is very important here, Howl and Other Poems. Howl and Other Poems is the title of his poem. And this poem originated this particular movement, Beat movement. Actually, these writers, the Beat writers, rejected formalism in poetry and materialism in society. That's why they called as Beat movement writers. They believed poetry should be personal and accessible. Personal poetry and accessible poetry. These are the characteristics of the poetry written in Beat movement. The major Beat writers we can identify here are Allen Ginsberg and William S. Burroughs and Jack Kerouac. These are the important three writers of this Beat movement. Then friends, diasporic writers, very famous name for in English literature, diasporic writers. So basically these writers include the names from India. V.S. Naipaul we can see here, then Salman Rushdie, very important one, then Amitav Ghosh, very very famous one, then Jhumpa Lahiri, Shashi Tharoor, Vikram Seth, Rohinton Mistry, Sunetra Gupta, Anita Desai, Bharati Mukherjee, and Hari Kunjru. These are the important Indian writers, but they are called as diasporic writers because they're born in India, but they live outside India at different places, in different countries. So first of all, let's understand what is diasporic writers. So it means a group of people coming from a particular nation or whose ancestors come from that particular nation, and they now live in other parts of other countries. So that is the important definition of diasporic writers. So a group of people who are from a particular nation, they are from a particular nation, they are born in that particular nation, or their ancestors come from that particular nation and they are now living in some other countries. And sometimes the forced migration is also there. Or voluntary migration by these people. So such people are called diasporic writers who wrote in literature. Okay, so that's why they called as diasporic writers, friends. You can note down these names for your reference. Then Tribe of Ben is there. Tribe of Ben includes the writers and the poets who followed Ben Jonson's style in poetry and drama. So it is also known as Sons of Ben. And these are the followers as written here of Ben Jonson in poetry and drama in the first half of the 17th century. Yes, in the first half of the 17th century they were. Then they wrote satires, pastoral poetry with naughty wit and conceits. So they used naughty wit and conceits in their poetry and satires, whatever they wrote, and following the style of Ben Jonson. According to Joe Lee Davis, these writers are, so here friends, Joe Lee Davis is a person who opined that, who said that these are the important writers. He enlisted some of the writers who were called as Sons of Ben. So these writers are Richard Brougham, Thomas Knibbs, Henry Grapthorne, Thomas Killigrew, Sir William Davenant, William Cartwright, Shackley Marmion, Jasper Maney, Peter Hosted, Thomas Randolph, and William Cavendish. So these are the important writers coming under Tribe of Ben. They are called Sons of Ben. And the poets, when we talk about the poets who followed the style of Ben Jonson, they were Robert Herrick, very important name, then Richard Lovelace, Sir John Suckling, and Thomas Carew. So these are important poets, friends. So these are called as Tribe of Ben or Sons of Ben. When we see here, these writers and poets were emerged in first half of the 17th century. Then Bloomsbury Group is there, friends. Bloomsbury Group includes artists, writers, and intellectuals. Three different personalities it is going to include here. So a circle of artists, writers, and intellectuals in the early 20th century. So in the beginning of 20th century, we can see a group called Bloomsbury Group in literature. They were keen on exploring the limits of thinking in writing, and on philosophy, humanism, gender issues, sexuality, and politics. So they included all these issues in their writing. Yes, they included all these issues in their writing. Here, friends, we can see writings by them, including philosophy, humanism, gender issues, sexuality, and politics in their different works. And the writers here, we can mention E.M. Forster, then John Maynard Keynes, then Duncan Grant, then Robert Fry, Lytton Strachey, Virginia Woolf, Vanessa Bell, Toby Stephen, Clive Bell, Leonard Woolf, and Saxon Sidney Turner. These are the important one writers we can see here, friends, who are included in this Bloomsbury group of literature. You can note down these writers for your reference, friends. Then, friends, last one of this video, Kailyard School. Kailyard School, very important name and very popular name in literature. Many times asked which are the following writers are not included in the Kailyard School of literature. So here we can see what is Kailyard. Kailyard means kitchen garden. Kitchen garden. The writers who captured stories of Scottish rural life, they are called as Kailyard School writers. This particular type of school of writing emerged in the late 1880s to mid 1890s. So for only 10 years, this particular writing was emerged in the history of English literature in 1880s and in mid 1890s. So at the end of 19th century, we can see here. And friends, major writers includes J.M. Barrie, John Watson, and S.R. Crockett. So these are the major writers of Kailyard School. Then all these writers, all the three figures here mentioned here, are from Edinburgh University. Edinburgh University is the university from which they studied, and they are called as the writers from Edinburgh University, included in Kellyard School. And friends, J.M. Barrie, if you know, J.M. Barrie is the person who is also the creator of Peter Pan. Peter Pan, the story, and also movies made on it, Peter Pan, children's story it is. So J.M. Barrie is the creator of that story, Peter Pan. And friends, here we can see the list of different Kellyard School writers. J.M. Barrie, as we have seen there, and McLaren, then J.J. Bell, and George MacDonald, and Gabriel Seaton, and Robina F. Hardy, and S.R. Crockett. So these are the important one, friends, in Kellyard School. John Watson is also there. I have not mentioned here, but he is also there in this Kellyard School, friends. So friends, here in these clubs or in these movements of different writers, what we can remember? We can remember the different names, but it is sometimes very difficult to remember all the names because we are confused between names. So what we can do? We can make a kind of shortcut, or we can remember only the major writers or major poets or the founders of that particular school or that movement. So major writers or the founders or originators we can remember here, friends. And one more thing, you can also remember some of the major works written under that particular movement or school. And also remember in which time it was emerged, in which century, mid 18th century, mid 19th century, or at the end of that particular century. So that particular time we have to remember, friends. Then one more thing, friends, I have also created one more video before some months regarding the literary movements. You can also go through my channel and watch that video. It is regarding Chartism, Impressionism, then Oxford movement, different literary movements I have added there in that particular video. So friends, that's all for today. And don't forget to watch my video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, because I am going to upload different videos on English literature in upcoming days. And I'm going to start a proper class for the literature works, literature syllabus included in different exams. So friends, that's all for today. And subscribe to my channel and follow me on my blog to have study material free of charge. And one more thing, you can go to my videos description box to have the links of different important books. Yes, friends, important books for your reference. You can follow the links and you can buy the books. Then, friends, that's all for today. See you next time and have a good day. Thank you so much.